can see there's smoke and fire. This is the entrance to one of the bomb shelters. You go in there and it goes down underground.
And we are really close to the Gaza border right now. You can clearly see these are all burnt.
Hi, it's Shlomo from Zo Artzeinu, from the Holy Land of Israel. How are you? Nice to see you again. Today, we're in a very special place. We're standing here with Daniel. Shalom, Daniel.
Hi.
Correct. We're on the Gaza border. We can't say exactly where because we don't want the terrorists, God forbid, I don't think they're going to watch this, but just in case they do, we don't want them to know where they hit so that they send off more kites. We're just near the Gaza border. It's a long border, and there's a lot of places where you can plant trees, and this is one of them.
We got some damage from the last fire here. You can see the forest surround us and avocado trees.
The fire reached this area of the forest, of the pine trees, and then it moved over to here, to this area.
Okay.
Wow.
I think that the damage was caused by a kite. And in another place, you see, it was an helium balloon.
A helium balloon. And when did this happen?
This happened 2 weeks ago.
Basically, they send these kites from Gaza.
From Gaza, yes.
It flies over and they light it with, how does it work? They have a Molotov cocktail on the bottom?
Coal, fire.
Fire coal. Like a barbecue.
Yes. It's a paradox that Israel give them helium for the hospital.
Helium
for the hospitals. They use this to send us fire here.
Tell me, how old are these trees over here?
14 years.
14
old.
Years. Perfect. And about how many trees do you have altogether?
More or less 5,000 trees.
Wow. Wow, that's unbelievable.
That means we have maybe close to 40 trees in this
right.
area.
So this area has 40, and then you said there were other areas
that had
a few hundred trees altogether.
Yes, correct.
Everybody that's watching this has helped plant trees in Israel before. And I told Daniel that we, Zo Artzeinu, are going to pay for all of the trees that were burnt down, and we're going to replant them. And I want to tell you something, Daniel. Zo Artzeinu has helped plant hundreds of thousands of trees all over Israel. And Baruch Hashem, I don't know what it is, we have a special blessing. None of the trees that we helped plant were ever destroyed. One of the most beautiful things about Israel, and I'm sure I'm saying the truth, you tell me, is farmers don't look at other farmers as competition.
Correct.
And we just helped a competitor not too far from here plant 5,000 avocado trees, and you're saying we should help them plant more.
Correct.
And we should help you plant more, and everybody in this area should be planting more. People in America or in Australia, they want to do something to help. They want to do something positive. They want something of growth. So bomb shelters are important. We just passed bomb shelters. People donate bomb shelters, which are important.
Yes.
But some people want to help do something grow. So they want to buy a tree. They really want to help. Okay, so nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Shalom. And Bezrat Hashem, the next time we come here, hopefully we'll see new trees grow.
Yeah, you will. You will.
Plant your trees now at IsraelTrees.org.